My name is Eduard Meyer, and I'll be explaining linear probabilistic modeling, or LPM for short. Linear probabilistic modeling is a special case of binomial regression, meaning that the outcomes are binomial, but the value is 0 or 1, with the main being yes and no, positive and negative, and the most popular in engineering, success and failure. One specific example of this would be seeing how production speed affects the number of failed circuit boards per hour. Linear probabilistic modeling is a way to estimate and model binomial outcomes using linear regression. It is given by the equation y equals beta 1 plus beta 2x plus epsilon. The dependent variable y takes the values of either 0 and 1 or binomial outcomes, and its probability is determined from the explanatory variables beta 1 and beta 2. The epsilon term is the random error term, and without it, the data would fall directly on the true regression line. LPM produces a line of best fit that models this binomial data set. And the line of best fit is the one that has the least amount of deviation from the data points, and it can be determined from the principle of least squares. Seen here is just a quick example of a line of best fit modeling some data that is not binomial. However, you can see the line of best fit modeling these six data points, with the random error being the distance between the data points and the line of best fit. This model is effective, however, there are a few drawbacks. One being that if there aren't any restrictions on the variables, and the model can produce results that are outside of the binomial interval from 0 to 1, as can seen here where the line of best fit falls below 0. It also may seem counterintuitive to model a binomial data set with a line of best fit, since most, if not all, of the data points will not fall directly on the line. However, the model still works, and it's effective, and its results can be used to make assumptions about the model that can help engineers in their work. An engineering example of LPM would be if a production control engineer wanted to monitor how production speed affects the failure rate of circuit boards. With a tolerance level of 10%, meaning that if more than 10% of circuit boards produced in an hour being defective is a failure with a value of 0, and less than 10% of those circuit boards being defective 1, then using linear probabilistic modeling, he or she would predict the probability of failure as a function of production speed. This model can then be used to see how many circuits can be reproduced without a large number of defects, since the company would want to produce as many circuit boards as possible, however, they would not want as much defects. In conclusion, LPM is a statistical method of estimating binomial data using linear regression that can be very efficient for engineers in many situations.